Crenshaw's new attitude to crime has appalled Dimmock. They continue their research, each securely locked within his own silence and conviction.
The one day they shut themselves in to preserve their ancient right of way. Oh well, they'll have to wait.
Not what I'm here for. Oh?
In fact, I'm a bit surprised at your setup.
Go on.
Cigarette?
You don't look as if you're, short of cash.
Why do you say that?
Well, you didn't arrive straight out of Birdland in that get-up, did you?
Ah, so they do come and see you.
To my ever-open door. Now, when you first come out, you're not that color. Bit more putty-like round the gills, eh?
So you're Drag Anglem.
Uh-huh. So what does that make you?
I don't know what I expected, really. I thought I knew it all. I thought you'd be older.
Right now, I feel. Oh, it's all that rolling, rubbing down old furniture. Agony.
Yes. Elaborate sort of cover.
No, it's not all that. Useful. Allows me to poke into all sorts of places. Old houses. One thing leads to another.
A lot of stuff comes in and out of here. No problem.
Yeah. It's like rolling off a rug.
Good. Good.
Right. Well, what's it all about?
I have a job for your boys. I want someone sprung.
Expensive. Dodgy. Could depend.
On?
Who, where, how much, and, not least, who's available.
Well, that's easy. I want George Bird out of Strange Ways. We can discuss terms.
Bird? George Bird? The bird that never flew?
Hey, Tom. Tom, come up here. We've got a proposition.
Organization exists instead of asking if one does.
I found two in today's reports. Would you care?
Oh, go on, talk to him. It's childish to...
No.
All right. But you know, I find it difficult to talk to him too.
What?
Ian has found two escapes for you in today's crime sheets. Or one, rather. The other one failed.
No outside help.
The one, a woman from Stile Open Prison. Don't blame her if it's anything like it is in here.
George Bird, safe breaker, recaptured in the governor's garden in Threnworth. Kerrigan needs a safe breaker. Ask Dimmock if it... No, don't bother him.
Kerrigan. He runs North London, doesn't he? Or perhaps Bird just couldn't stand another dreadful weekend inside.
If you and Dimmock are both on the side of the escapers, what results can I possibly hope to get?
I was just saying to Ian that the program you've asked me to put through won't work. It assumes that an organization for getting people out of prison exists.
It does not. The Home Office's memo merely asks me to review the continued organization of prison escapes in the light of recent security changes, and all I've asked you to look for is significant similarities in those escapes that had outside help.
But that's a blatant assumption.
Oh, really?
Oh, all right. Put yourself in, Chucky.
You're both wasting your own time and mine. I'm sorry, but the program won't work. This is not just a simple job for the index. I must have more information about the escapees themselves. Our escape's only arranged for prisoners with special skills, like Bird, who's a safe breaker, or for prisoners with a specific need to escape.
Oh, I see. I'm sorry, Mrs. Hollandcheck. How long will all this take?
Some time, if we're to verify our information. And we must, if we're not to waste the computer's time as well. The Institute was very unwilling to sell you even an hour.
We must get it right. Work.
I'm sorry, Cam.
You both keep apologizing. It's awful.
In trying to devise a new penal system, Oldenshaw seems to be forgetting one thing.
Wouldn't you rather be saying this to him?
Yes, but he refuses to... I agree it's stupid, but once one person starts being petty... Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, no. No apologies. Soon I won't even dare say anything to you.
So the joke's on me. I just hadn't heard.
I'm sorry I couldn't end. Well, you look so serious. I mean, you didn't know about old Dickie, brother.
The bird that couldn't fly.
All right, we've had our little chuckle. What happens now?
Nothing.
You mean you won't take it on?
Not won't.
Can't.
Bird in solitary is just about the best looked after man in strange ways, wouldn't you say? Well, apart from the governor.
It's been done before. I thought you did this kind of thing.
I do. But the jazzy days of the spectacular breakouts are over, mates. No more removal vans, no more geraniums to mark the spot. Fin-fin, finito.
A man in solitary is like a one-armed window cleaner. He just can't win.
Here. What if it did break his arm?
Oh. Be your rage.
It may not buy the governor, but it'll help. $1,000 and another when you pull it off.
It looks good. Very pretty. But it's not on.
If I understand you correctly, with a broken arm, a fellow would have to go into hospital, right? Well, broken up, he's no use to me, of course. But work on that hospital idea. Sounds promising to me.
Where do I find you?
When Bird comes out. When, mark you. I'll know. No mistaking this time.
We're not promising.
No, but you're trying. That's all I ask. Oh, by the way... The less noise, the better. The hospitals are quiet places.
Yeah, and you can have a lot of symptoms for £1,000.
That's it. You seem to be listening. Good lad.
Well, what's wrong?
Just stop having ideas, that's all. Your sort of idea, you'll end up inside again. Doesn't make any sense.
It's a lot of pop, you know.
Yeah. The baited hook. I don't mind whether there's a sporting chance, Tom, but...
Look, Drag. Now, I may see things a bit too simple. But look at it this way. You feel it a bit low, a bit stiff. Right. Half an hour's workout on the mat. Bloody lovely. Well, isn't there some way we could sort of, turn it round the other way?
Well, you mean you feel fine, you do a couple of exercises, and they count you off sick.
Oh, well, it's something like that, I mean. We could help Birdie. Stands to reason.
I never heard of it. Now, we could get him to slash a wrist or two.
Too messy. Dickie Bird's in Chokey for being a naughty boy, right? 28 days. Lots of time, all to himself. He can get plenty of practice in when no one's looking. Because no one is looking.
Yeah. Make himself sick as a dog.
Right.
Murray might know a trick or two on that line. He could help us, yeah. Who do we know in strange ways?
No one just now, but Barney just come out.
And if I know Barney, he'll be back down and Murray's getting into shape.
Yeah, great operator.
It's too dodgy to use him. Someone will have to get up to Manchester to find the way in.
Well, I'll go, Drag.
Not so fast. We'll see. If you and I do find out a trick or two on that line, we're going to have to make sure that they work.
You mean that all these are organized escapes during the last 4 years?
Achieved or failed, yes. This column shows the failures. Here, technical knowledge available only outside prison. You see, there are very few examples.
Very clearly and simply. Does a significant number of these examples look to be the work of the same organization?
If the answer were as simple as that, I could leave the whole thing to you. The frequency of coincidence of these factors is little better than random, for one of two reasons. Either our sample was wrong, or the answer is so negative as to be useless.
Is the answer either yes or no?
Neither. We can't tell.
Thank you, Mrs. Ollinger. That is a very clear statement of our position. Do you think the crime rate in Britain would rise if we were to alter our system of punishment so as to do away with prisons altogether?
I can't think of one other possible program that might do away with prisons altogether. What in the world did he mean by that?
By what?
I think he must be thinking of hulks or transportations or devil's islands or something. He just said, couldn't we do away with prisons altogether?
I don't know what he's thinking. I haven't had so much of a glimpse of his report. But he must offer the Home Office something more than 50 pages of solemn head-shaking. And it is an imaginative question. It does suppose.
For somebody other than him, perhaps.
Not even for Oldenshaw. The study of our present prison system is not usually a very imaginatively liberating exercise.
My goodness. Do you mean prisons aren't like Piranesi's etchings of prisons?
They're certainly not dramatic. A camel. A camel is a horse designed by a committee. It attempts to reconcile irreconcilable functions in a solution which is almost entirely ludicrous.
I feel sorry for the camel, though.
One does. And for the prisoner in his prison. To attempt to reconcile a view of prison as a place for punishment, as and as a school for the re-education of the mistaken, is a delicate balancing act.
And in performing the act, we tend to lose sight of the imaginative possibilities of both views.
Yeah, that is what I meant.
But what did Oldenshaw mean?
I don't know, yet. At present, he is absorbed in the dynamics of high wire walking. We must wait till he falls off.
Hello, darling. How are you?
Hey, what you doing around here, all pumped up? Hey, get in here. Oh, look, he put him down. You can see by his gear, he's got soft. I wish I'd put you lot out on the square like in the old days.
Okay, Sarge, I can hear you. How are you doing, you old bastard?
Yeah, you can get that 90-guinea shark skin off him. Let's see ya.
Don't worry, Sarge, don't worry. I got one muscle left. Here. I want to talk to you. Well, you're not exactly packing them in, are you?
Not what it was, Jack. No, definitely not what it was. Now, they're all going soft these days, straining their ankles down at the old bowling alley. Candy Foss generation, eh? Yeah, I thought I might be seeing you here, though.
Huh? How come?
Well, a fellow around here the other day asking for you.
Know him, did you?
Yeah, I knew him. Big time. Kettigan.
So that's who it was.
Hey, what's he want?
Come in here.
Yep. Well, now, what can I do for you?
Hmm? Well, it's tricky, Sarge. I need good advice, and I'll pay.
Ah, you don't have to do that. You just name it.
Don't take this wrong, Sarge, because I need help. But, you never were in the army, were you?
Hey, now look here, mate.
Sarge, baby, I said don't get me wrong, you know, but all this Sergeant Major bit, you were in Jug in 39, weren't you?
Yeah, well, that was a bit of a giggle, see? When I came out, I didn't fancy it. I got other things to do.
I know, you're a lousy old phony. But you're a big, strong fella. How come they never took you for a soldier?
Couple of tricks the doctors went up to.
That's what I thought. Like?
Hmm? Well, no. Didn't like doing it, of course. But, well, like I said, I got things I was busy with. And the old mum was still alive then. Yeah, I remember.
Come on, now, Sarge. Come on. Now, I don't mind. What was it?
Paraffin injected under the kneecap. And one or two extras. I don't like to remind myself.
Do you know any others?
Yeah. Yeah, what do you want to?
Well, a friend of mine's got to look sick for a couple of days. Very sick and no hardware.
In the First World War, the Jerrys used to drop pamphlets to our boys on how to malinga. Trouble smoking.
Involve too many people.
No, yeah, you don't want the barons on your back. Manage pills.
Depends.
Oh, no. What was it they used to give to our boys in the jungle for malaria?
What?
Mepocrine, was it? Yeah, that's it. Mepocrine, yeah. Used to turn them all yellow, especially the eyeballs.
Like jaundice.
Yeah. Mepocrine's difficult. It's obsolete now.
Would it be enough, Sarge?
No. He'd have to have other symptoms. Itching all over. Mind you, that means enough on the blanket.
Hold it, Sarge. Yeah? Hold. Tell me, Emma, how many pills?
Well, a lot, 10 of them.
10 or more?
Oh, 50 at least.
50?
Well, crash course.
What do you mean, Sarge? It can't be done.
Here's something. Insulin. 2 tablets to be swallowed. That'd do it.
What had happened?
Well, he'd sweat a lot, double vision, then he'd go into a coma.
Well, what's the drill?
Well, look, if he's in Nick, get him to lay off the starchy stuff. No bread, no potatoes for 24 hours.
Well, that's all he gets in there. Want to starve the poor sod, huh?
Well, he can have protein. They'll ignore the first attack, and then after the second, they'll put him in hospital for observation.
Hmm. Would they treat him in prison?
No, not after the third attack. Then they put him outside somewhere proper. How's that, eh?
Great. What would he be like afterwards?
Oh, well, it wouldn't be nice when it lasted, but it'd be all right afterwards. No after effects. Oh, and no tea, of course.
Tea?
It's always sugared.
Sarge, any particular tablets?
Any sort of insulin will do. Proclor, what's his name? Here, look, here, at the double. Oh, and Drac, don't go blowing it around about the paraffin, will you?
Sarge, as if I would. Oh, by the way, look, I need Lofty and I want to see Barney Goodstone, right? Cheers. So, what do you get for breakfast? Fruit juice. Hello, that's all right, isn't it? You're laughing. Yeah. Well, it's not bad, is it? I mean,
gotcha. Saw you again that time.
no good. I'll have to use a flatter box.
Need a cover.
There's nothing more risky.
It won't work else.
New newspaper gloves is too suspicious. No, it's got to be something that works.
Here, look, try this.
Who'd take a book in on a prison visit?
Go on, try it. For me, eh?
Oh, yeah. So they give you fruit juice for...
Of course, what you really need is your handbag.
hey, Windmill. Handbag. That's it. A bird.
Get a bird?
Yeah.
Well, that's it then. I'll get Jean out tomorrow. We'll have a practice.
Yeah. She's sharp, all right. She's got a cool head. Oh, we're laughing, mate. Huh? Hey, I'm starving. What you got for supper, huh?
I've got a nice little shepherd's pie.
Spuds, are you mad? What do you think I'm paying you for? I'm off Cabo Edres for 24 hours, remember? Must know what it feels like afterwards. Because that's when he's got to be able to move. Afterwards.
Any luck this morning?
No, none. No reaction at all. He didn't even get cross.
He listened to you?
I don't know whether he heard me. He simply allowed me to speak my plea for reasonableness.
And afterwards?
Hmm?
When you finished?
Oh, he said yes, meaning no.
Do you really mind?
Of course I mind. I worked with him for how many years? Seems like 20. No, 7 altogether. Magic number.
That sentiment. Really?
How much, in the end, does one care for anything or anybody?
I don't know.
Then why ask?
You left a perfectly interesting job in the States to come and work here, in this backwater, as you've called it, with him.
Yes. Some people. Very few illuminate the world. Others absorb their luminosity. I'm an absorber. You know how you can read an essay, a book review even, which can, by its beguiling sanity, lay waste whole areas of previously held convictions. Well, Oldenshaw was like that, capable of it. Now he's degenerated into ordinariness. Packet of pre-digested prejudices. You might as well be anybody now.
All right, love. That's it. That's him. Wouldn't do to get the wrong fella, would it?
You sure he's not coloured or something? I mean, me being his sister.
Well, I don't know a hair like that. Nobody ever take it for natural.
I may laugh, Dan.
Oh, and the ciggy. Don't forget the ciggy bit.
Oh, come on, we've done it often enough.
Yeah, hey, look, you better get in there. You don't want to be late. Hey, don't drop the fag. And you.
prisons were built before the invention of the motor car.
No, that isn't quite fair. After all, some of our open prisons were built a little...
An open prison is a contradiction in terms. You can only contain the less lethal criminals in that sort of prison.
It is just like a summer birdcage in a garden.
Less lethal? What is a less lethal prisoner?
One whose crime was an aberration, a sudden crashing of the social gears without premeditation. The kind of criminal we are studying is an advanced driver between the lines.
But from what you've been saying, I rather gather that all prisons are more or less open, to the professional, that is.
Not quite so open as they were.
Well, information comes and goes. Personnel are trained for future operations.
Metaphor.
Yes. I've caught it from you.
Has the leopard changed their spots?
No, it's German measles.
Coco?
Yes, please. Since it seems to be a visiting day.
I've got a pretty sister.
Hello,
sweetheart.
Don't blow your mind. Yeah.
What's it all about, then, darling?
Don't worry too much. You'll get your cup.
Well, what about a date in 26 months' time?
You'll be on crutches, man.
Be nice, darling.
Oh, come on. I'm only your sister, remember? Not that that'd worry you too much, though, would it?
You're right, you are.
Oh, Christ.
Oh, don't worry about me. I'll survive. Pity I can't make it this evening, though.
I know. You're busy.
Visitors may not smoke.
Oh, I'm ever so sorry. I'm ever so sorry. I just wasn't thinking.
All right, you won't think.
Well done, darling. You know, you just do for me.
I'll bear it in mind. As far as the door, man.
It's been lovely seeing you. Watch you walk away. Not too fast.
For your pleasure, anything at all. Ah, never mind. Your turn will come. You can go back to sleep now.
Not just yet, sister. You're too hard.
Well, ta-da.
Ta-da, darling. Write to me.
Hello, Drake? Yeah, well, it's gone through lovely. I think we just heard. Yeah. You coming up here, then? What? Oh, yeah. You're waiting in his mood. Okay, then. Yeah. I'll see you. No, I've got to go now. The town is out. Okay. Yeah.
You.
Keep quiet in there, Bird.
Morning, Anthem.
Left your room open, have you?
No.
How am I going to clean it, then?
I'm just off to the library.
Ah. Is he in?
Yeah, but don't disturb him.
It's the third day. It'll be like a pigsty. He used to be such a clean gentleman.
Hello? Tom? Yeah? They moved him last night.
Great.
Yeah, fine, Tom. Huh? No. You get down here right away, huh? Oh, well, listen, bring a plan, will you, and we'll see what we need. Uh-huh. Well, Molly says it'll be a couple of days before they shift them outside. And then we'll have to move fast. Huh? Nah, just watch for that ambulance, that's all. Well, by the way, bring that map of the hospital, will you? And get Lofty to spell you, huh? Right? Uh-huh. Okay, then, see you later. That's a bit of luck anyway, eh? I bet at the end of a public ward might have been tricky.
Yeah, well, with Dickie Bird, you see, they won't take no chances.
Oh, the entrance to the private wings in the garden. How do you get the stretcher cases in there, huh?
Well, they just wheel them through from the main block here.
Yeah. I see. Where's the nearest point to the street?
Over there. It's where they have those trash cans. You know, the big ones with wheels on?
Uh-huh.
And, this is an alley that leads to the side street.
Well, that's where we come out, mates. Is it a gate?
Yeah, but not that it's open all the time. They're in and out, you know.
Uh-huh. Many warders in the room?
Well, one for certain, but it's hard to tell.
You want for one?
We'll manage.
Right. Time for eats and a quick shift. Molly says I'll have to shut up with sedatives, leaving till morning.
Yeah, will we get in a private ward all right this time of night?
Yeah, get in any time. Bunch of roses, box of chocolates, and a sob story. So, 2.5 hours to Manchester, that'll make it 7. So, 7 it is.
And Lofty at the back with a car.
Lovely, marvellous. Phone him back, eh? Oh, right. One more to us.
He let you in, then?
Hmm. I told him. The college rules state that a don's rooms must not be left for more than 2 days. Oh, they get nasty. He'd gone 3. Up there.
I see.
Do you know why that rule was made?
No idea.
We had a man here once, locked himself in his rooms for 2 weeks. Ate nothing but marmalade and garlic sausage. The head porter, finally, got authority to break down the door. Whew. Well, the smell alone nearly knocked him backwards. And all the fella said, who was green with mould, was, Mr. Mockridge, thanks to you, the secret of the universe will never be known. On your head be it. And then he threw the empty marmalade pots. At the head porter, mind you. Of course, I had to take him away then.
To Xanadu?
No, to hospital.
We must be careful, Anthem. Persons from Porlock.
Porlock? Mr. Mugridge comes from Hemel Hempstead.
Thank you.
darling.
Oh,
I guess.
It was kind of you to agree to play.
Please.
Sitting with the patient.
What am I supposed to say to that?
I don't know. What's Dimmock doing?
Working.
A newfound application. Oh, may I?
Yeah.
Sorry. Oh, no, we're not to apologize, are we?
Convenient if you were to speak to each other again.
I dare say. But I prefer to wait until his conscience stops patronizing me.
Or you found yourself a new one.
I have found one.
How does it work?
Quite simply, easily. Less.
Less?
The criminal has none at all. He harms us without repugnance or remorse. He must be discovered, then confined with maximum efficiency.
Devil's Islands?
Parkhurst is a nod in that direction. Mind you, Queen Victoria used to go to the Isle of Wight too.
Please, your little likenesses unnerve me.
The chief difficulty of a prison is that it is community contains for the prisoner, within the rigid framework of its discipline, a chumminess, a spirit of we are all together in adversity. This we must break down. No more subversive Dunkirk morale. Each man must be re-imprisoned within his own personality.
As you are.
As you are.
Well, I agree, there's no escaping from that.
No.
How is all this to be brought about, practically? What recommendations have you made?
Less communal activities, more solitary confinement.
You can't seriously think that that would help.
It's not meant to help, but to prevent.
And escapes? What relevance have your reports to escape?
A very pertinent one.
Predetermined escapes are the result of information. Information is passed from mouth to mouth. Cut the opportunities for communication within a prison and you will prevent escapes just as surely as if you had built a perimeter wall.
Put everybody in choking. Is that your solution?
Crudely and somewhat unfairly stated, yes.
Suddenly I agree with Ian. I think we must begin with you. Good night.
Yeah, but you were winning.
Did you beat him?
No.
Pity.
I would have. I didn't wait to finish the game.
Why?
That was what he asked.